sleep.
Alright, what's up guys? It's been a while since I've done a YouTube video. Well, actually, technically it's not, because you probably would have seen the upload I just did. Well, other than that, it's been a while since I've done a YouTube video. So, what we're going to be doing today is we're just going to be going to the gym and hitting some chest and back, which is part of the split. It's Sunday. It's usually my Sunday routine. Right now, we're on the way to get a boost of energy from the gas station. I'm going to mix that with some pump, and then we're going to go straight in the gym and really put in that work today. We're really trying to build up some mass. It's coming to close to summer, so I'm really gonna, you know, start focusing a way of trying to be like lean or whatnot. I feel like I got as lean as I wanted to be, or you know, I could have maybe gone a little bit more, but overall, I feel like I really reached the point where I felt good. So now we're gonna go in, you know, start doing some bulk up. So now we're gonna get really, really serious in the gym. So yeah, we're gonna go in there. We're gonna get an energy drink. And then we're gonna really have to put all that energy to work, because it's like 6 p.m. right now, which means I gotta totally waste all that energy before 9 p.m. by going super hard in the gym. Call me rancid or whatever, but shit. I'm about to use this cup right here and pour that monster in here. This is like a day old, but it was just water, so I think we're gonna be fine. Monster down there. That way we can get some raw pump in here. Because the whole point of going to the gym, other than building muscle, is to feel bigger than you already were. And although the pump is great, it's not the most important thing. But today on chest and back, it's a hard thing to pass up when you already feel so jacked from just like the pure squeeze and contractions of chest and back, the two opposing muscle groups. So yeah, we're just gonna mix this together and then, yeah, we'll be on our way.
Anyways guys, like I said earlier, welcome to the vlog. Today we're just gonna be doing some chest and back, starting off with these T-bar rows. I always like to start out with back first, just because I feel like it really helps me retract my scapula for all the pressing movements. And then right after this, we're gonna just be doing around like three working sets, really trying to go to like 8 to 10 reps. We're gonna be going hitting some chest flies, because I really like doing that as my first chest movement, just because I feel like it really works the shoulders, you know, warms them up, along with just pumping blood flow into the chest. But yeah, just a little warm-up set with no weight. Try and really focus on feeling those muscles engaging. I know you guys hear me grunting on these. It's not because it's heavy, it's just because that's the way I do it. That might have been a little heavy. Ooh. Get off. Drop set it, because we didn't get to the reps we wanted. To fill it. All right, I think we've hit the T-bar rows. Good enough for today. All right, now what I'm gonna just be doing, moving on to the chest flies, really working on pumping some blood into the chest, warming up the shoulders before I go do some heavier incline presses. So yeah, let's just get right into it.
Summertime, summertime, summertime.
for my chest flies, I don't really push these things back too far because I had a labrum tear in my shoulder. So it really kind of affects me going super far, and I'd rather not go farther back than I have to, because I still feel like I get pretty good stretch and contraction just setting it on the second pin. First pin, I don't know, I felt like it was a little, you know, not enough stretch. Second pin was just right. Anything past the second, it's a no-go for me. Two, three, four, five. All right, come on, baby. We got three more left in the tank. Two more left in the tank. But I think there was seven. We'll go for two more because I lost count. We finished doing the chest flies, and now we're gonna be moving on to some close grip lat pull down, utilizing this little mag grip attachment. Feel like it gives you a better contraction overall. Just gonna do a little bit warm up set. I know it's a little bit later in the workout to be doing a warm up set, but I like to at least do one warm up set on the third exercise. Just to make sure I'm really getting blood flow and feeling the contraction the way it's supposed to be felt. We've increased the weight. I'm gonna pull this for a nice little eight. Pump cover's gotta come off. I'm gonna throw this bad boy around the chain. Hopefully it doesn't make too much noise for you guys. Gymshark stringer on. Don't wanna tear anything. Just gonna nice and control. And then pull. Don't get mad at me, sometimes I don't go all the way down, and that's just because I feel like my muscles are burning enough right there, which I know doesn't mean they're being worked to the maximum extent. They're just what feels comfortable with my body, and I don't want to push it too much harder than I feel like it could be pushed, especially with my shoulder. Sometimes it gets a little bit wonky there, and I don't want to, for some reason, have it give out, all that good stuff. All right, so now that we've completed the first three movements of our workout, we're gonna be heading into some incline press to work on the upper chest, because I feel like that is particularly where I'm lacking the most. So we're gonna be working on that. Put a wrist strap on because I got a little bit of a weaker right wrist. Shitty camera placement. Hopefully this is gonna be a better angle for you guys. Last one, weight was kind of going through, in and out. The reason I've been working on my upper chest a lot is because I feel like I've been lacking in my lower chest, and I need to make my upper chest like overshadow that, because there's not really an easy way to just work your lower chest. And if you take it, I don't really have the lower chest on that side, maybe a little bit on that, but still not. So I need to make the upper chest a little bit more thicker, which is why after this we're gonna do one more back, and then we're gonna be just doing another incline movement. All right, I lied. Instead of back, we're just gonna be doing some pressing movements because I feel like my back is a lot more pronounced than my chest. What we're gonna be doing is just some low to highs. But for these, I kind of got a little tip for you guys. So normally for low to high, you'd grip them like this and just bring them kind of like this. But if you guys are experiencing any sort of shoulder pain, what you want to do is just raise them a tad and then re-grip them and set it up kind of, instead of scooping like that, you want to set them up so you're more in a pressing motion. I found that it creates a lot less strain on the shoulders and attacks the chest. Oh, just as good. I lied. All right. After this, we're just gonna do three sets bicep curls, because yesterday I decided to go boating instead of hit the gym. I woke up later. I was supposed to, wasn't as committed yesterday. So we're gonna just do really quick biceps sets. My arms are kind of already fatigued from the back that we did. So figure why not, you know, totally just take it to failure. Last set of these. I decided to scoop. Go against my own advice I just gave you guys. Why? Because my arms look better this way. Fucking big chest. Pump. 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 Cause you know this sound in the middle. Some days you feel bigger than the other, yet you're still just as small. But we'll get there. Oh, we've exhausted the chest, back. Now, I'm just gonna cap it off with some arms because I didn't do arms yesterday, like I said. And, you know, really trying to get those arms looking a little bit bigger than they are. Knock out some curls real quick, and then we'll be on our way home. nipples popping out. Every time this shit happens with the nipple right there, it's like the equivalent of a sneaky ball, except it's a nipple, which is definitely better, but it gives those weird vibes. Power out these reps. Diabolical pump. Really hammering it out. Good stuff, y'all. That is the end of the workout. Hope you guys enjoyed it. We're gonna go home and grill up some lean ground bison, eat it with some rice, and then edit this footage. As always, guys, I'd like to say thanks for watching the video. Without you guys, I couldn't really be doing this. So I'll see you guys in the next one. Hope you enjoyed. Leave a like and a comment down below if there's anything you want to see. See you guys.